Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Dragon Ball Nation. Now today I got an interesting video discussion I've brought. Of course, introduce yourself, my friend.
Yes, I'm not going to call myself Daddy this time. I am Big D from Geekdom 101. I'm happy to be here and I'm happy to be discussing this because as many of you know, including you, I hate misinformation and let's put a stop to it together.
Yeah, and today we're going to be talking about the, really mainly the Dragon Ball Wiki, but I want to really make this into a discussion talking about why you shouldn't go there for your main source of info, where you should go so you're not misinformed, and stuff like that. We're not putting people on blast here for, let's say, you know, doing stuff on the wiki. There's generally some really well-informed people on the wiki, but at the same time, there's a lot of misinformation on the wiki. It's not correct stuff. Some of the stuff isn't even from any of the dubs of the show, and it's stuff that's pulled out of thin air. And we're going to talk about where you should get your information as well. So I'm going to hand it to Geekdom right now to let you guys know.
I just want to say this. I'm not in any way disrespecting Dragon Ball Wiki as far as the people who built it, because obviously it took years to build. And you mentioned Konzenshu. There is a planned Konzenshu Wiki, and I'm actually on the team for it. The problem is that it's nowhere close to being done because they're literally building it from the ground up and it takes a long time and they don't want to have it online until it's actually complete. So that might be a while. I mean, who knows? But I just wanted to say, before I did YouTube, before I met you or any of these other guys, I always had...
Before your life changed for the better, yep.
Pretty much. And you're right about that in many ways, actually. I had an issue with Dragon Ball Wiki, not because they were totally inaccurate, because look, if you were to ask me how accurate are they, I would say, you know, 60, 70%.
They get some stuff right. I mean, there's some quick information you can actually learn off there, but for serious stuff, I mean...
Yeah.
You really shouldn't be going there.
And we'll use some examples real quick here for the people. I had a problem with them because they referred to Frieza's empire as the Planet Trade Organization. Now, I checked with Juan. I checked with a few guys. This was... Okay, the Planet Trade Organization is a name that was not used in the Japanese version ever. And it was not used in the dub either. And I had to double check that because I was thinking maybe I missed something with one of the dubs. Maybe the big green dub or one of the... No. The Planet Trade Organization is a name that they made up. And other people who use Dragon Ball Wiki as a source have cited it. And so I can tell right off the hop if somebody actually watched the series or if they went on Dragon Ball Wiki if they mentioned the Planet Trade Organization. That's one that is 100% made up by them. Another one, which I talked about recently in a video, is about how Vegito unfused inside of Majin Buu. The only actual statement about Vegito's defusing of Majin Buu from the manga and the anime is that for some reason when Vegito dropped his barrier, the air, the atmosphere inside of Majin Buu defused them. That's it. But on Dragon Ball Wiki, they claim that, oh, it's because of the stomach acids, blah, blah, blah. That's not what was stated. It was made up.
It's so not even in the dub either.
No, it's not.
Mind the people
it's
watching
not,
this.
It's nowhere. And that's the thing, is that you have to understand that it's not all wrong, but if you're going to go to Dragon Ball Wiki and you have a question about something that sounds questionable, again, I've always said, critical thinking skills. If you go on YouTube and you have a YouTuber say Broly comes back in Dragon Ball Super, just using as an example, or on a website, think for a minute. Okay. Broly's not a Toriyama creation. He was created by Takao Koyama. He's not in the manga. He's not in any of the Toriyama authorized, you know, anime stuff. I mean, except for the three movies, which he did help draw Broly, but he didn't create Broly from scratch. And he's not really, you know, he's basically a character people love. He's not anything that Toriyama's ever even spoken of. He's never even spoken of Broly, except for one interview where he said that he helped draw Broly. So again, critical thinking. Okay, that's probably not true. Same thing with Dragon Ball Wiki. It's just hard sometimes to dissect what's true and what isn't. That's the problem, is that it's hard to figure out what is true and what is not true.
That's why you need to use Konzenshu, because you have guys on Konzenshu like Herms and other people that know Japanese, that have been with the series for so long, that have all this outside information that is, I mean, if they've ever been incorrect, and Danny, I'm sure if they've been incorrect, you would know about it, because you're the most knowledgeable person about the Konzenshu site in Dragon Ball that I even know.
Well, I appreciate
that. Tell people just about why Konzenshu is so important, why they should go there rather than the wiki. Maybe the wiki's a little bit easier to digest, I suppose. You have to dig a little bit deeper in Konzenshu and go on their different tabs, but it's worth it to have all the information.
Yeah, I just want to say that one of the issues with Konzenshu is that sometimes what you're looking for is kind of hard to find, which is not really the fault of the web designer so much, which is Hujio. It's more so that the way they categorize stuff, the search option is not, like, if you're looking for a specific thing, especially if you're looking for it with the dub name, it's going to be hard to find on Konzenshu because they default to the Japanese names. So the important thing to do is to sign up for the Konzenshu message board, and then you can ask questions directly there, and somebody will help you, whether it be Herms, whether it be Julian, whether it be AJ, whether it be Kaboom. All the mods there will answer your question. Nobody ever gets ignored there. So that's the best thing to do if you have a question, honestly. Or you can ask one of us, of course. We have Ask FMs, unfortunately. But, no, the reason why they're credible is not only do I know some of these guys, not super personally, but I've worked with Herms many times. Herms is an accredited N1 Japanese speaker. He went to Japan for 2 years to study abroad. He speaks the language fluently, can read it fluently. Julian, not only did he go to Japan, he married a Japanese woman and also speaks and has 2 kids with her and also speaks fluently. So there's very few people out there who actually speak fluently. And I will say this. I will just say this also, Josh. Dragon Ball Insiders, another good website. My buddy Nemura Netta is also a Japanese interpreter, so they have a good one there too. And then, of course, Ken Zyro on Twitter is another good one from the Pafu subs. So there are good ones out there, but the reason why you should trust Konzenshu is because Konzenshu pretty much has their fingers in every pot. Scott from Team Four Star, Kaiser Neko, he started off on the Konzenshu board. I was lurking there for years before doing YouTube. It's just almost everybody in the community who's credible goes to Konzenshu. So essentially, you should trust them because they've been around 15 years. And if they weren't credible, they would have died a long time ago. So it's just the way that it is. I don't work for them. I'm just saying I don't.
You've been around there long enough to know what you're talking about. And that's, you know, that's honestly in the end up to the viewer to be like, well, this guy's full of shit, or, you know, hey, this guy knows what he's talking about. That's up to them. And hey, they can live their life the same way either way. And the way I look at this whole situation is, you know, we're not telling you have to go here or you have to watch the show a certain way. Guess what? I grew up with a dub. I went with a dub for a very long time.
Yeah, it's not even about that.
But I want to say, like, if you think that's the version that you like the best, you don't care about the rest of it, you're like, I'm going to go on the wiki to freshen up on my stuff from the dub, guess what? Go for it. But if you're going to start a YouTube channel about Dragon Ball or come at us and say we're wrong, and I'm not doing this out of anger, I'm just saying, hypothetically, because it's happened before, come at us for saying we're wrong about something and do, you know, A, B, C, D, point these out, things that you got from the wiki or that from the dub, which is not the original source. If you're going to do stuff like that, you need to know what you're talking about on, you know, the original material, whether that's from Konzenshu, Dragon Ball Insider, or the official guidebooks, which also you'd find on Konzenshu. So I think it's just something that's important.
Yeah, and they're in Japanese. I mean, that's the whole thing. It's not that. Yeah, this is not about dub versus sub necessarily. It's more so about just getting yourself informed. Like, if you're going to leave a comment, argue. And here's the thing. I've been wrong before. You've been wrong before. You mentioned Konzenshu being wrong. Herms actually was fooled by some fake episode titles about 2 months ago. And that mistake will never happen again. But it wasn't actually even published on Konzenshu. It was just on his Twitter. You know, things like that happen. But actually, another story is that I remember they were fooled. You'll love that. I don't know if you know this story or not, but there was a leak for Budokai Tenkaichi 4, which, no, for real,
I never heard this.
Years ago, there was a Budokai Tenkaichi 4. It was going to be called Sparkling Ultimate or some shit. And there was, like, apparently, like, a almost legitimately credible source. I don't remember exactly where. Konzenshu reported it and got burned. And ever since then, a lot of those guys are very hesitant to post the news. They're basically not going to double source everything because it actually looked legit. Like, it looked like it really, it, from what I understand, they were, it wasn't like a dumb, like, clickbait thing. It was somebody who they knew who claimed to have this to be a fact, and it wasn't a fact. So, I mean, they have in the past, but, you know, just like me and most of us who have integrity, if we screw up, we'll tell you we're wrong. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. I'm not going to just make a video saying something wrong and then leave it like that. If I mess up, I've never been wrong about something major, that like a report on anything like major news that's been wrong. If I ever report on any news that I've really been wrong, I'm always very cautious on stuff I put up. And if I ever am, and if you ever are, you'll be damn sure you will take those videos down. They
won't stay
up.
I already did it before.
Yeah, those videos will not stay up, and we will have update videos letting you guys know that we were wrong and giving you guys the real information, you know, giving you the sources that we have, which are most likely will be on Konzenchu or from Herms' Twitter or wherever. But it's just, you can watch, again, this, and just reinforcing this, because I know some people are going to get this twisted no matter how many times I say it. There's going to be those certain people. You can watch the show however you want. I don't care. It does not affect me. If you love Dragon Ball, that's already good enough for me. But do not question people that have extreme knowledge of this series. I'm not claiming that's me, but guys on Konzenchu, Danny, and other people, well, don't like go in. Don't go in there and like question them and say they're wrong about things when you know you don't really know what you're talking about as far as the official material goes. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah,
enjoy the show. Just don't criticize others when you don't know as much as them,
well,
I suppose.
Well, no,
It sounds like an asshole no matter what, but it's a fact that needs to be laid out. It really is.
Well, what you're trying to say, because I don't want people to get offended, because they get offended. I think.
Well, I'm an asshole. It's hard not to.
I know. me too sometimes, but I think what you're trying to say is before attacking somebody, and you shouldn't attack anybody, but before, you know, making a statement, just make sure all your ducks are in a row. That's pretty much what it is, so to speak, especially if there's evidence on the screen too, because sometimes you'll have evidence on the screen that will say this, you know what I mean? So, but really, you know, at the end of the day, just critical thinking and double check everything, you know. And even if you think that, you know, one of us is wrong, like if I do a video about something, check Dino, see if he did one. Check, you know, right, like Josh or anybody, because if your
chances are,
yeah,
we're gonna have our sources cited, and I'm not gonna name names because I don't want to draw any attention. But if you see people that make questionable videos or stuff that you think like, huh, I haven't
talked about this before,
talk about this, that, you know, stuff that you haven't heard anyone else talking about, number one, look to see if they have a source. And sometimes I'll forget to cite a source, but when I do cover stuff, it's pretty much stuff everyone else has covered. Number one, look for a source, and number two, look to see if anyone else talked about this. And if they didn't, chances are they're not. It's not like, hey, I got an inside at Toei or something. No, it means that they're full of shit. Now, I'm not naming names, so I'm just leaving it off that. Make sure that, like you said, all your ducks in a row.
Yeah, and there's people. I don't have an inside at Toei, but I know people who have insides at Toei. A friend of a friend of a friend, let's just say. And yeah, trust me, if it's real, it'll be out there from one of us. And
you'll know it first.
You will. It all comes down to like, okay, if you see a YouTube video by someone, I'm not going to name no names, of course, we're not doing that here, and it sounds just totally outlandish, and like you said, if nobody else reporting on it, it's probably not. But by now, I'm sure most of your subscribers, and most likely almost all of mine, are already aware of who the culprits are, and I'm not gonna name no names who put out the fake information. And you should know when you see a video by them, please do not tweet at me or at Josh and say, look at what this guy's doing, look what he said. It's not gonna accomplish anything. Report the video or ignore it. That's it. Don't watch it, don't sub. If you know the guy's full of shit, we know too. I promise you that we know. I'm not saying we've had 3-hour conversations about it, but maybe 5 hours, but we know. Right? Everybody knows who's bullshitting around here now, bro. The game has changed. This is the post-geekdom era. The game is over now. Now that was egotistical. That was too much. I take that
back.
That's
why we all love you. But Danny, is there anything else you want to say before I close out this video?
No, that's it.
I think we pretty much covered all the bases.
Yeah, the only thing I want to say is I'm going to speak to the people from the heart. The reason why I don't like misinformation is because I don't like having kids lied to. And a lot of the viewers of your channels and mine are like younger people, you know, teens.
Exactly.
and kids. And I don't like kids being lied to, bro. I'm not one of those guys that likes the Easter Bunny and Santa Claus, dude. I'm just, I want to be very honest with everybody, dude. And I hate fucking liars. I hate misinformers. And especially since when we do a video, you have people trolling us saying we're wrong when we're not wrong. You know, and sometimes we are wrong. But I mean, in general.
Sometimes we are. And we accept that.
That's right.
It's human nature to be wrong. You can't be perfect. You can't.
Yeah. And that's why it's important, I think, like I said, to be as honest as possible, because eventually if all we did was lie to you, eventually all those subs are going to grow up and say, fuck this guy, he lied to me. And that's where, at the end of the day, all the liars are going to end up going under one day. That's real shit. It's going to happen.
Yep. it happens in time, but I mean, other than that, there's pretty much nothing else to say. Everyone, take everything from what we said, you know, take that to you, to wherever, I don't know. Think about it. Definitely think about it. Don't just watch the video and, you know, live your day again. You know, you can do that, but think about what we said. Take everything what we said for seriousness, I suppose. And subscribe to Geekdom, of course, because he is probably the...
Nah, bro, come on. Don't even say
he
it.
He is the most credible Dragon Ball YouTuber.
Until Herms gets a YouTube channel, then I'm fucked. Then I can only be a silver medalist.
Yeah, subscribe to him. Link down below. I have to thank him for being on this video with me. I couldn't have picked a better person that knows more about Kanzenshi to do it with. I know, you know, Fat Mike wouldn't have done it, so.
Are you leaving that in?
No.
Oh, damn it. All right. Well, that...
I might just cut this part right here.
That's it. It's over.
But thanks for watching this video, guys, and I'll catch you later.
Yeah.